station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Kayla LaFrance. This week, astronauts on board the station have been taking out the trash. The crew has been busy packing and preparing the Northrop Grumman Cygnus CRS-10 resupply vehicle for its upcoming departure from the station. Cygnus arrived at the station back on November 19th. After the crew unstowed over 7,000 pounds of new supplies, they began to fill the vehicle with trash that has accumulated on the station over the past few months. There's no trash pickup in space, which means that the crew has to stockpile it until a vehicle is ready to depart filled with thousands of pounds of disposable items, ultimately burning up in the atmosphere during re-entry. Be sure to tune into NASA TV on February 8th to watch Cygnus depart live starting at 10:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. NASA astronaut Anne McClain teamed up with students on the Earth for a high-flying robotics competition. The Spheres Zero Robotics Experiment is a competition for high school students that has them write algorithms for free-flying robotic satellites, programming them to accomplish complex tasks in space, such as docking, assembly, and formation flight. The competition provides these students the opportunity to act as programmers and ground controllers, giving them hands-on experience with real research in space. The first flight of NASA's Commercial Crew Program is right around the corner. SpaceX successfully conducted what's known as a hot fire test with their Falcon 9 rocket on the launch pad at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. This was an important milestone on the road to Demonstration Mission 1, or DM-1, an unmanned test flight and the first mission of a new spacecraft designed to carry astronauts to the International Space Station. DM-1 is currently targeted for February, so head over to nasa.gov/commercialcrew for the latest updates. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.